السلام علیکم. بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی رب زدنی علما. اوکے ناؤ چلڈرن، ہاؤ آر یو؟ ہاؤ از ایوری ون؟ آئی ہوپ دیٹ یو آل آر لرننگ، انجوائنگ یور لرننگ. اف یو آر فیسنگ اینی پرابلم دین یو کین ڈیفینیٹلی کنسلٹ می. اوکے، ٹوڈے وی آر گوئنگ ٹو ڈسکس ون مور پیپر، پیپر ٹو، کمپیوٹر سائنس Algorithms, Programming and Logic, that is May-June 2023, Paper 2-2. You all know that paper is of 1 hour 45 minutes duration. You have to answer on the question paper. There's no additional material that is needed. You have to answer all the questions. Please carry a black or a dark blue pen with you. And you can also carry an HB pencil for any diagrams or graphs. Write your name, center number and candidate number in the boxes at the top of the page. Write your answer for each question in the space given. Do not carry an erasable pen at all. Do not write on any barcodes, calculators. Please do not carry. Again, they are not allowed in the examination hall. Paper is of 75 marks. The number of marks are given at the end of each question or the part question in brackets. No mark will be awarded for using any brand name or software package or hardware. So please refrain from writing down the brand names. Let's start. Question number one. Tick one box to identify the first stage of the program development life cycle. So we all have learned the PDLC stages. So it's simple analysis, a one mark gained. Question number two. Four logic gates and five standard symbols for logic gates are shown. Draw one link to each logic gate to one line to link each logic gate with standard symbol. Not all symbols will be used. AND gate, you can see this one is the AND gate. So simply draw a line. OR gate is this one. NAND gate is AND with a NOTing symbol. And NOT gate is the triangle with a NOTing symbol. In this manner, 4 out of 4, you have gained. Identify three different ways that the design of a solution to a problem can be presented. Very simple. You are asked to design the solution to a problem. So what you do is, a person or a programmer or an analyst can draw a structure diagram or a structure chart. He can draw a flow chart or he can write pseudocode. So these are the three options available. Student has written these answers correctly. He will score 3 out of 3. Now, question number four. A program needs to make sure that the value input for a measurement meets the following rules. So these are the criteria given. The value is a positive number. A value is always input. The value is less than 1000. Mean that these are the three conditions. Let's see what the question says. Describe the validation checks that the programmer would need to use. There are 3 marks. It means that you have to write down 3 valid points. The first one is range check, because you are asked to enter a value less than 1000. So it means range check is with acceptable values, like for example, greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 999, perfect answer. Greater than or equal to 0, greater than 0 and less than 1000, that's also a correct answer. For the value that is less than 1000, range check, please be cautious. Presence check, and that is needed to ensure that the value is always input. If the value is not input, the program will not continue. It will ask for the user input once again. So that is what you need to again mention to gain a mark for proper description. Type check or character check. And this is needed to ensure that number is entered. Right, fine. No letters are required. No letters are acceptable. It will only be accepting the digits. And that is why the type check or the character check is the right option. Length check to ensure that there are not more than 3 digits being entered. Again, length check, because a person, since it is not being mentioned that the data type is a string or integer or whatever. So that is why a student may think that the length check is appropriate. Thank you very much, Ali, for raising this question to remove the ambiguity. That length check is needed in situation if, for example, the number was entered as a string value, it was not entered as a digit or as an integer value. In this case, length check will be appropriate. So if a student has written these three options with the correct description, he will definitely score 3 out of 3. Part B1, the program needs editing to include a double entry to check the value input. State why this check needs to be included. To verify the data, for verification, as a verification check, correct answers. Or a student has written to make sure that no changes are made to the data on entry. He has actually explained it in a little, he has also tried to explain it. So that is also accepted as a valid answer, and the student will score 1 out of 1. The input value needs to be stored in the variable measurement. Write pseudocode to perform the double entry check until a successful input is needed. Until a successful input. So here you can see what we need to do is we have to write down a proper pseudocode. So just for your benefit, they are mentioning the details that how are you actually scoring the mark. A 3-mark question means that you can score if you have used the proper iteration, you have taken 2 inputs because we are just comparing the 2 values to check that the 2 inputs are same or are they different when in anything. Use of the given variable measurement, that is very, very important that you need to see that this is also they are going to assess that has the student used the proper variable, the same variable as was in the question. Just an example, repeat and until. Inside this, you can see 2 inputs with the proper messages are there, enter measurement and then input measurement, the same variable measurement. Output, please re-enter measurement, and definitely we have to take input in another variable. And then the 2 variables will be matched until measurement equals to measurement check. So you can see if the measurement is not matching with measurement check, so the program will reiterate, it will ask for the input once again because the 2 are not matching. But in case measurement and measurement check, these both are same, it means that it will not reiterate because you remember repeat until works when the condition is false. It stops working when the condition becomes true. Okay, question number 5. Circle 5 file handling operations, and you can just go through it and let me know what do you think are the right options here. Yes, what do you think are the right options here? Calculate? No. Close? Yes, we do close. Count? No, we don't perform count as such on this. Create, input, open. Correct. Then do we sort? Do we read? Yes, read. Or you can say write. By the way, there are 5 handling operations needed, but out of these, we can figure out only 4. And this question's answer has been removed from the marking scheme for the reason because there were some ambiguities. That's why we have removed. But still, just for the purpose of understanding, I've included here because you can see for yourself, these are the operations that we have learned. We have learned to open the file. We have learned to close the file. We have learned to read the contents of the file by using read file. And we have written the contents to the file by using write file. So that is why I have just discussed this question with you. So that something similar to this, if it comes in the paper, you are able to answer it. Okay? Understood?